Newton's spherical coordinate system, and this comes from the geometry of a sphere. In the last video we already discussed about a cylindrical coordinate system. Now look at this: x is equal to rho cos phi, y is equal to rho sin phi, and z is equal to z. This already comes from the cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, so the lower part is exactly same as that of a cylindrical coordinate system. And now just look at this upper part. The point P is joined to the origin by a vector r, and we have drawn one perpendicular to the z-axis from the point P. Okay, this distance is rho, which is exactly similar to the radius vector, and this distance is z because this is the height of that cylinder. Okay, so it is exactly same. Now we will use this triangle to find out the relation between x, y, z and r, theta and angle phi. Okay, now from the cylindrical coordinates we already have these three things. Now look at this triangle OP and z. In this triangle OPM, cos theta is equal to adjacent side is this z divided by hypotenuse, that is r, and therefore z is equal to r cos theta. Similarly, in this same triangle, sine theta is equal to opposite side, that is rho, divided by hypotenuse, that is r, and therefore sine theta is equal to rho upon r. That gives us rho is equal to sine theta. Okay, now putting this value, rho is equal to sine theta, in equation 1 and 2, we obtain this: x is equal to r sine theta cos phi, y is equal to r sine theta sine phi, and z is equal to r cos theta. This is called as the spherical coordinates. Okay, now note that in spherical polar coordinates, r always varies from bigger than 0 or less than infinity, that means a finite number. Theta always varies from 0 to pi, not 0 to 2 pi, and phi always varies from 0 to 2 pi, that is 360 angle. Okay, in cylindrical coordinate system, rho is the radius vector that always varies from bigger than 0 to less than infinity, that means a finite number. Phi always varies from 0 to 2 pi, and height is minus infinity to infinity. Okay, next we will study the distance formula. This comes from the Pythagoras theorem. Suppose we have point P which lies in the xy plane, and its distance from the origin is simply given by r. Okay, so let us find out r by using Pythagoras theorem. We have r square is equal to x square plus y square, and therefore r is equal to square root of this x square plus y square. That gives the distance of the point P from the origin. Similarly, in case of 3 dimension, we have 3 axes x, y, z, and therefore r is given by distance of the point P from the origin is given by square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Now let us extend this concept to the arbitrary point. Suppose we have 2 points, P1 whose coordinates x1, y1, z1, and p2 whose coordinate x2, y2, z2, then the distance between these 2 points, that is shortest distance, which is these 2 points are joined by a straight line, and therefore their distance is given by r is equal to coordinate wise you have to subset x2 minus x1, so it's square, y2 minus y1, that is y2 minus y1 whole square, plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Students, note that here doesn't matter whether you are taking x2 minus x1 or x1 minus x2, because simply you are taking square, so distance will not get changed. Okay, now next important point is the direction cosine. In case of direction cosine, okay, suppose we have point P x having Cartesian coordinate x, y, z in the 3-dimensional space, and let us join this point P to the origin by having distance r. Okay, now angle made by this line with the x-axis is alpha, angle made by this line with the y-axis is beta, and angle made by this line OP with the z-axis is say gamma. Then the quantities cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, which provides the information about certain direction in the space, are called as a direction cosine, or that is called as a DCS of line OP. Now for convenience, we are using this notation: L is equal to cos alpha, M is equal to cos beta, N is equal to cos gamma. Let us obtain the direction cosines of the coordinate axis. Okay, now DCS of x-axis is 100, because x-axis is perpendicular to the y-axis and z-axis, that makes angle 90 degrees. Therefore beta is equal to 90 degrees, and gamma is also equal to 90 degrees, and therefore cos beta become 0, and cos gamma also become 0, and cos alpha, that will be cos 0, and that will be the 1, and therefore distance of x axis is 100. Similarly, we can obtain the distance of y axis, that is 010, and the distance of the z axis, that is 001. As we know that cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are the direction cosines of the given line OP, and this is the important property of this direction cosines, that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1, that is L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. This is well known identity. Now we will study direction ratio. In any three numbers A, B and C which are proportional to the direction cosine L, M, N respectively of a given line are called direction numbers or ratios or DRS of the given line. That is L upon A, M upon B, N upon C, where A, B, C are DRS and L, M, N are the direction cosines of given line. Now let us obtain the relation between DCS and DRS of a given line. So if A, B and C are the DRS of a given line, then their direction cosines are given by L is equal to plus minus A upon square root of A square plus B square plus C square, M is equal to square root of plus minus B upon square root of A square plus B square plus C square, and N is equal to plus minus C upon square root of A square plus B square. You can obtain this proof of this from using this property. Okay. Now consider this line joining two points M and N, M having coordinate x1, x2 and N having coordinate y1, y2. Then what are the DRS of this line? So it simply is you have to subtract coordinate wise y1 minus x1 and y2 minus x2. That gives the direction ratios of this line MN. Okay, suppose we have line joining two points P1 of x1, y1, z1 and P2 of x2, y2, z2. Then direction ratios of this line given by x2 minus x1, coordinate wise subtraction, that is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 and z2 minus z1. Now we will study angle between two lines if the distances are known. Okay, suppose we have two line OA and OB. The distance of line OA is L1, M1, N and distance of line OB is L2, M2, N2. Then the cos theta. Okay, cos theta is equal to L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2, or in terms of DRS, cos theta is equal to A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 divided by A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into square root of A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. This is the formula. I'm going quickly because these are the preliminary things that we will require while dealing with the sphere. When we study sphere, cylinder and cone, these are the concepts that we will require. Okay, now next is Lagrange's identity. So these are the DCS L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, M2. So L1 square plus M1 square plus N1 square in another bracket, L2 square plus M2 square plus N2 square minus this cos theta square. Now you know cos theta is equal to this, same formula is there. So this exactly equal to L1 M2 minus L2 M1 square plus M1 N2 minus M2 N1 square plus N1 L2 minus N2 L1 square. Look at this pattern, L1 M2 minus L2 M1. So here is N1 and N2 are absents. Look at this pattern, you can see here. Now since sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta, therefore 1 minus this quantity is whole square, because cos theta is equal to this, and therefore and this 1 minus cos square theta, that is 1 minus this thing whole square, is exactly about this from the Lagrange's identity. Why this so? Because L1 square plus M1 square plus N2 square is 1, L2 square plus M2 square plus N2 square is 1, because we already know this, that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to 1, this property of DCS, and therefore the product become 1, and 1 minus this things exactly this from the Lagrange's identity, and therefore 1 minus this things, that is from the Lagrange's identity, is exactly equal to this thing. Okay, now therefore we obtain sine theta is equal to square root of right hand side. Okay, now condition of perpendicularity and parallelism. So using this above formula, we will obtain the condition of perpendicularity and parallelism of the given lines. The given lines are perpendicular if the theta has to be 90 degree. Okay, the angle between them has to be 90 degree. That means cos 90 degree is equal to 0. So using this formula, we have L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0, because theta is equal to 90 degree, that gives 0. Or in terms of DRS, we have this A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 is equal to 0. And the next point is a parallelism, that two lines are parallel if theta angle between them has to be 0. Therefore sine theta is equal to 0, and we already know this formula, sine theta is equal to this term, and therefore square root of this term is equal to 0. Therefore individual term inside the square root has to be 0, and therefore L1 M2 minus L2 M1 is equal to M1 N2 minus M2 N1 is equal to N1 L2 minus N2 L1 is equal to 0, and therefore we obtain this ratio L1 L2 is equal to M1 M2 is equal to N1 N2, or in terms of DRS it is A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 is equal to C1 upon C2. If these two conditions or one of them condition holds, that means the given two lines are parallel to each other. Okay, students, in the next video we will learn projection of a point or projection of a segment of a line, the plane plane, angle between two planes, general equation of plane in some particular cases. Then we will move to the important point, that is sphere. Okay, thank you.